then you call it called Kennel Project. So what you do is you donate a certain amount of money and they actually buy a kennel for dogs. And then a nameplate gets placed onto that dog kennel. Not this dog. Right, so if we can ask Maxine and Peter to come up and just quickly read the poem. Start with that. Jimmie and Rodgers, English Country Garden.
How many kinds of sweet flowers grow in the English Country Garden? I'll tell you more about some of those I miss. You should be pardoned. Daffodil heart season flocks, very sweet ladies' flocks, genteel, little tall holly hearts, roses, fox, gold, snowdrops, floating clay pots in an English country garden. How many insects come from here to go to our English country garden? I'll tell you more about something that I know and those I miss. You should be pardoned. Fireflies, moss and bees, fires climbing in the trees, butterflies that sway on the cool, gentle breeze. There are snakes, ants, and stinging, and creepy things in an English country garden. Many songbirds fly to and fro to our English country garden. I'll tell you now about some that I know, those I miss, you surely pardon. Bobolink, cuckoo, quail, tangier, cardinal, bluebird, lark, fresh and nightingale, there is joy in the spring when the birds begin to sing in an English Robin, don't forget the Robin.
things. Nick has been at the ready to organize and book flights and drive her up and down. Nick badly wanted to be here today, but unfortunately felt ill to treat his flight. Thank you. It gave me a lot of comfort with you alongside me at Martin's. Martin, you took charge of the house, the meals, the children, anything that needed doing to free me up. You spent time with Mom. Thank you. Betsy packed her own lunches, waited patiently to school if I was late to fetch her, and studied hard even when I wasn't at home. Tamsin checked in when she could to see how we were all doing and how I was doing. Thank you, guys. Mom and I made our way through many ups and downs, heartache and disappointment with our very odd sense of humour. We figured if we were laughing, there was less time for tears. And up until Sunday, our silly jokes and our flow of hurries kept us going. Little did I know that on Sunday, when I walked out of the hospital, it would be the last time that I left Mom awake. My mind wants to reject it, but this is reality. My mom is no longer with us. She had diverse interests, many hobbies, enjoyed time with family and friends. She grew up in the southern suburbs, traveled to Australia, America, and the UK, and she was always up for some fun or a party. She's left us all beautiful memories of adventures that we've shared. Mom, I wish we had more time. A reunion, so to speak. We had so many plans, and you're looking forward to your new adventures. First on your list was a rib rye and a whiskey. Or a hip ski, or You got me through Dad's passing, and now I need to navigate yours alone. I'm lucky, though. Our family, my friends, and all your friends who by default became my friends too, all of them are with me. I thought we had more time. I was wrong. I hope I made you proud and approve and you approve what you're sending off. Rest easy, Mom. You'll be missed. Lots of love.
Play a song that you also chosen. Stick Figures, Angels Above.
Thank you.
please come up and
Sue was, and will always be, my big sis. Our mum always said Sue kept asking our parents for a sibling. 8 years later, she got me, and after my two. When I was young, my mum was ill, and again later, when our mum nursed our nan, Sue looked after me, a big responsibility for a young girl. My earliest memory is of her playing with me in the sand on the Bishop Beach. And I had to draw me this down. Of their marriages and life, later moved us apart. We would always pick up right where we left off.
Xavier, run, follow the sun.
Thank you.
representative please come up and introduce yourself and your team, because it was a team, and hopefully there's some interesting stories.
I hope so. Hi everybody. I'm Karen Bailey, I'm a friend of Sue's, I'm from the ladies' lunch group that you hear about. First thing to Peter and all your family, we sincerely condolences from every single one of the ladies' lunch group. We're all totally benefited by Sue's capacity so suddenly, and we're all in shock and still are. Peter asked me to share some words with you all on behalf of the ladies' lunch group, because we get together and we have serious but mostly fun times. It was a group that Sue loved to get together with and enjoy the time with a very, very special bunch of ladies who come from all walks of life and truly support and nurture each other. I'm going to go through one or two things that some of the ladies have handled through every single one of them here all day. But I'm going to go through one or two. Tracy McNulty-Coots was the one who first led Sue to work and introduced her to the ladies' group, which we did was 13 years ago. Tracy shared a couple of memories, which I'm sure you will enjoy, so this is from Tracy. I first met Sue when she was working for a company that supplied our software. We hit it off immediately. When we went to a training course for a week at the Bini Spa, for some reason, everybody had quite a few drinks on the last night. Sue and Tracy and I, Tracy, were so deep in conversation, they totally failed to notice that some of the guys were playing strip poker and wandering around naked. Sue and I laughed about that often. So, this is so from Tracy. Sue was one of the few non-family members at Tracy and Hugh's wedding. Her office was just up the road from where we got married, and she and guys from the office arrived, too late for the actual ceremony, but in time for a few drinks. Sue, Miriam, and I, Tracy, were known as the witches of Eastwick, and they all worked together. I think it still stays. Tracy to remember that she thinks the first night Sue came to was Kate's 50th, the Italian Club. Which we think it was. And another great lunch was when Tracy organised a surprise lunch for Sue's 60th birthday, which we had at Fairies, and she had some of her previous colleagues join Sue at that. It was good to make Sue feel very special. Sue also joined cooking, was a fabulous cook, and she also introduced, it doesn't show, but she did introduce us all to Banting. That was from Tracy. I'm going to share with everyone the group that said that although anyone wanted to give me something, do allow me to share one or two or more from the ladies' group. These are words from Martin Milan, sitting in the back here. I've known Sue since 2016 through the ladies' lunch group. A very quiet person, hardly says a word. Slowly over the years, we started chatting more and more, and in 2020, she started visiting me at home. Her project was to assist for about 120 boxes of books that Martin invented from her late brother. It was some of the best times that I got to know the real Sue, sharp, witty, with a wicked sense of humour. She was always keen to get a debate going, making some shocking statements to get a reaction. And lo and behold, if you dared answer with an emoji, that was a deadly combo. We got that a lot on the major, no from Sue. I remember her telling us one time that she went to the sofa party for an AIDS test that was clear. I followed her in total shock and asked, why on earth would you need an AIDS test? It turned out it was just to play a hoax so that we could get a reaction, get some conversation going. I find you and my friends have suddenly hard to accept and have so many memories in my home. Sue and Martin says we did a lot of bartering. I miss you, my friend. Another one of our group, Michelle Andrew, shared this with us. Michelle says, my boyfriend Jimmie is a PJ, is a singer, and Sue loved his music. She joined us often for his live shows, especially during COVID, and sent many messages of support to them. Sue once asked for one of his videos, which she admitted to watching often, and said it made her day. Michelle says both herself and Jimmie will miss Sue, as she's always a kind of day for both of them, and one of the most genuine people they knew, so RIP Sue from Michelle. My sister Catherine Clubs lives in the UK and only met Sue once, but she had to say as well, year at my 16th birthday, and she was all made up and looking so pretty and oozing confidence. She was up dancing, having a great time, and it was good to see her so happy and enjoying herself. She did like those special birthday parties. We had a few, because there's a few of us ladies. And Kim McNulty, another one of our ladies, did an amazing photograph tribute to Sue last week when we, a few of us, met at her home. It was sad, and it was the first time we'd actually got together, but it was sad, but at the same time, it made us ladies share our memories. And we had great fun remembering the events and the pictures. And I know Kim is going to share the pictures with Peter shortly. The one person that Sue spent a great deal of time with, especially the last few years of setting up the back, is Anna Marie Jordan from our group. And this is the tribute I want to finish this with, the tribute that Anna Marie wants me to share with you. It's from Anna Marie Jordan. Welcome to one and all for attending this celebration of Sue's life and mourning her passing. When I first met Sue at our ladies' group lunches, I observed that she was somewhat invisible. With her pixie haircut and bare-faced look, she would spend most of the time in quiet observation. Something about her spoke to me. I knew there was a better Sue there somewhere, and I resolved that I would help her find another way of being. So I took her on as my project. We did all talk about that project from time to time. And she graciously accepted Adelaide's patronage and became a willing student. It was a fun time for both of us, as I encouraged her to grow her hair, apply makeup, and never, ever go out without lipstick. One day she delightedly told me that a nice gentleman had flirted with her in a supermarket. I hoped there would be many more such encounters. Sadly, it was not to be. Her sudden passing has, I'm sure, caused us all to reflect on our own lives. It is a reminder that happiness should not be based on material things, for those are fleeting moments, but on simply being content. Content with our lives as they are. It is a state of mind which will grant us peace as we navigate the stormy waters of life. It was what I wished for Sue in her moments of highs and lows, ups and downs. And in her final weeks, we communicated almost every day. I saw great courage in her and I was very proud of her. There will come a time for each of us to ask ourselves the question, what legacy will I leave behind? What evidence will I leave that I existed, that I achieved anything, that indeed I made a mark? Rest assured, it will not be the house, it will not be the car, it will be the people, the family, and the friends you have made. Sue became an important part of my life, Anne-Marie says, and she will live on as I reflect on our times together in the future. She was invaluable in always being there when I needed her in my many times of incapacity, and I am forever grateful for that. But she has left a wonderful legacy in her daughter and her beloved grandchildren. She loved them all very much and would often boast of her granddaughter's achievements. We did get that at the ladies' lunch a lot, but that was good. Her memory will continue with them for many generations, I'm sure. And therein lies the legacy. Rest in peace, Sue, and that was from Anne-Marie. Thank you, Anne-Marie, for sharing those two special words and sharing your special thoughts of Sue. In conclusion, Sue was a very loyal and great supporter of the ladies' group, and there were very few get-togethers when she did not join us over the past 12 or 13 years. Every one of us has such special memories and photos to share, and we will do so over many years to come. Sue's passing really is the first one in our group, and we are all truly saddened. But the memories we have can never be replaced, and Sue will be remembered often into the future. In Marty's words, and from the ladies' group, we will all miss you, Sue. Yes,
yes, now that is how we need to remember Sue. Having fun. Just the last bit of formalities. Just want to give a thank you to all that is here. And if I missed anybody, please forgive me. Just thank you to everybody. All the neighbors of Cherrywood Road, they helped a lot.
during her stay there in the neighborhood and even after she's left us. You've guys were a big help. You helped Peter with the house, with inquiries, with a few questions that we had. Thank you very much to all the neighbors. Then obviously the ladies' lunch group for their friendship, words of comfort, and daily well wishes to Sue while she was in the hospital. Then in one city hospital nurses and sisters of the wards E and F, Dr. Stein, Schuler, Else, Liedem, and Lewis. Sue regularly told us how she was treated in the hospital by the doctors and the nursing staff. And it was absolutely wonderful to hear how they actually handled her and all the tests and stuff we done. My dad also has cancer. He's got cancer for the past 8 months. And in that 8 months, they haven't done half of the tests that they did on Sue for the 8 days. So in one city, great stuff. Very well done. Then to all the family, friends, ex-colleagues, people attending the memorial, thank you for your support and your attendance. Lastly, just to add Bob, especially Antoinette, Peter thought shopping was for funeral policies for Sue was real, but it paled in comparison to organizing the memorial and carrying out Sue's last wishes. Then of course there's been comforting, gentle, kind and supportive throughout the entire process. So lastly, before we end, I just want to open the floor. If there's anybody in here that wants to say anything, more than welcome to come up. That would be a good time. Okay, that's perfect. Thank you very much. So for the next 10 minutes, we can just mingle, we can talk to each other, and then we will depart. So if you guys want to join us, like I said, at the Bossas in Burgundy Estate, you're more than welcome to. We'll be going from about, say, 11:45. All right. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you.